I'm not touching anything that came from that motel.
Well, if we want to find out who else was in the attic, we got to go through the records.
Oh, hey, guys.
Yo.
Hey.
Allow me to introduce you to someone. This is Richard Duvall.
Hey, how you doing?
How are you?
As in Ricky, Elena's son.
I'm sorry, what?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, actually, I prefer to go by Richard, but it's nice to finally meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you, too. Your mom said you were at camp.
Yes, sir. Camp Pendleton. I'm a staff sergeant there, home on leave.
This is so awesome.
Oh, I know.
Is something wrong? I mean, were you expecting someone else, or...?
No. I was expecting a big, tall, you know, grown adult man like you.
Okay.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Nicholas, but I heard about your little visitor, and I thought he might like these coloring books.
Okay, Ducky.
I couldn't decide between magical unicorns and choo-choo trains, so I brought them both. They're really quite delightful.
So I'm guessing those are for me.
Perhaps I should have brought bigger crayons.
It's okay. I just figured I'd take initiative and we'd grab lunch, but obviously you need to spend some time here.
Yeah, we're swamped. Rain check?
It's no problem.
Right.
So, it was very nice to meet you, Ellie.
Yeah, it was really nice to meet you too, Richard. Hey, Ducky, you mind escorting him out?
Not at all. This way.
See ya. How did you get his age so wrong?
Elena didn't tell you how old he was?
I don't know, man. Marvin Gaye was playing. Uncle was involved. I guess I just wasn't paying attention. Oh, my gosh, she's old enough to have an adult son.
Just imagine, if you and Elena get married, you'll be his dad.
Now, something's funny.
Oh, yeah, boss. Torres.
Go, give me an update. Let's go.
We're still waiting on the final autopsy, but DNA has confirmed our victim is Master Gunnery Sergeant Aaron Shaw, married, two kids, highly decorated.
Sounds like a pretty stand-up guy.
Then why was he staying in a fleabag motel?
Yeah, so his house is only 20 minutes from the motel. There's no obvious reason for him to have been there.
I'll give you a reason. He was cheating on his wife.
He had the motel room for an entire week, never even used it.
So maybe Shaw was the peeping Tom. It's always the ones you least expect.
Well, if Shaw was the peeper, maybe someone discovered what he was doing and killed him for it.
We need more about Shaw.
My husband was a good man, a decent man. Why would anybody want to kill him?
Did you notice anything off about how he was acting recently?
No, I mean, he was tired more. He'd been working later hours.
Why later hours?
He took on a side job, something with the military. He couldn't tell me much about it, so.
Mrs. Shaw, can you think of any reason your husband would have had a room at the Monarch Motel?
No. Was he having an affair? Why do you keep looking at each other? I mean, what are you not telling me about my husband?
Mrs. Shaw, we found hidden cameras inside the same motel your husband checked into.
Wait, and you think that Aaron had something to do with that?
We're still gathering some facts here.
No, I know my husband. He would never do that. He's a loving husband and father. He's not some kind of, like, sex pervert.
Listen, we're not saying that he is, okay? I know this is a lot to digest, but voyeuristic disorder is less about sex and more about secrets. And from everything you're telling us, it sounds like your husband had a lot of them.